How about now? Can you hear me on the stream? How about now? Maybe? Oh, you got me? All right. Hey, stream. Oh, that sounds like me. That sounds like me with a slight delay. That's gonna drive me insane. All right, folks, get started in a minute or two. Last call for the open projector here. If anyone wants to hop on the open projector, come up and share something. Got a little live coding for you here on the stream. Thank you. Yeah, I want to really hear that crowd. Okay. All right, everybody. Let's give this a try. Oh yeah! What's up, everybody? You're here at Baby Castles on a Thursday night for WordHack. Make some noise with your hands and faces! Woo! Yeah! Oh yeah! Live studio audience here at WordHack, live here on the stream. Really, really excited to have you here tonight. What's up, everyone? Hey to our streaming viewers on the Baby Castles Twitch stream. Very, very excited to have you with us here as well. We've got an exciting show for you tonight. I'm Todd Anderson, and we've got Eliot Linton here to talk to you. Yeah, let's give it up for Eliot. Woo! Oh yeah! And we're going to have a special digital online performance right to our screen and stream from Fernando Ramallo. Please give it up for Fernando. Woo! Oh yeah! So this is your first time with us, either in person or digitally. WordHack is a monthly show we run here at Baby Castles. It's the third Thursday of every month, but that's kind of a trick question because it's actually the second Thursday, but it's usually the third Thursday of every month. We've been running for just over 5.5 years now. And it's a monthly gathering dedicated to exploring the intersection of language and technology. So we have writers, we have artists, we have game makers who are working with language in interesting ways. We have technologists, we have linguists, all sorts of people from different communities who are approaching language with different goals, different ideas, but all with this kind of shared common desire to play with it and see what's possible with language in a different space. We kind of create a space to bring those people together, have some short talks and performances, hang out, get to know each other. Really excited for the show we have for you tonight. We have a tradition here. My background is in poetry. And so when I first started doing shows in New York, it was really important to me to be able to go to a poetry event and sign up on a piece of paper and read my poem out at the open mic and get to know people that way. So we provide a similar opportunity here called the Open Projector. I'm going to go see if we have anyone on our Open Projector. Wow, coming up first on our Open Projector is Todd. Woo! Oh yeah, wow. It's thank you. Thank you. I'm excited to be here with you. One thing I've been thinking about as kind of we're entering our social distancing phase of our lives is different ways that because I am a web artist of sorts and think about different ways the internet and websites can make us feel together. I have a project that I'm working on that's in this idea called Hitchhiker, where you can collectively browse websites together. We experimented with that last November. But I just think of different ways we can experience something together. So I'd like to invite everyone who's watching, either in the audience or home on your computers or devices, to hop on over to this is a past project that we've shown at WordHack, yourworldoftext.com/together. So Your World of Text is a project created by Andrew Botter, and it's a kind of infinite grid of text space where you can type in any direction. And every different potential domain name has a different, every potential subpage has a different thing in there. So if we did yourworldoftext.com/gopherunderground, this could be a new one just for Gophers Underground. But we're slash together here. And this message started out for some other people. Would you like to be with me together in this world? It's better than being alone. Okay, that was there before. But now we can kind of be together here with our audience. I encourage you to have a little time here. And say, hey, everyone. It's me, Todd, from the stream that you are seeing. Or not. It's me today. From the strum. Oh, we have some exciting characters appearing above us. Oh, I wonder who will come follow me as I head over here into the sunset. Oh no, the sun has already set and it is becoming very dark. And now, just now, I have realized that I am running out of water. I sure hope someone can bring me some water. Please put some water into my hand so I can drink it. Oh yeah, that's the good stuff. I am ready to keep going across this desert at night, because even though I feel like I am alone sometimes, I know that you are here with me as I am on this journey. Oh no! Oh, that was just my shadow. I thought it was a stranger, but really, it is just me plus some light. And oh, it's a ghost. That's very spooky. But I feel like I... Oh, hello, stranger. How are you? I have places to be, so if you want to chat, please walk with me. I think we will be at the ocean soon. I would like to see the ocean one more time. I have brought with me a microwave oven that I bought on overstock.com, and I would like to introduce it to the ocean so that they can be together. And also I would like to see a turtle and make it become a friend. It is scary. Oh, ooh! A sea lion. That's... Oh, hey, clams. I think we may have made it to the ocean. Hello, turtle. Will you be my friend? back. I want to hear what you... Oh. Yeah, I hear you. Parenting can be a lot sometimes. I understand you, Turtle. I will throw my old car batteries into the ocean. Well, here we all are together in the sea. That's nice, isn't it? You and me in the sea. That's all for now. Thanks. Woo! Okay, yeah. Oh, all right. Wow. So, that's where finished all of our open projector presenters. Thank you to everyone that signed up for the open projector. And we can get started right ahead here with our first featured presenter, who has been really excited to have him here for a featured slot. She's been a longtime guest of a recurring favorite on our open projector to rave reviews. Excited to he's a programmer, poet, doing some exciting puns in Python, lots of alliteration for you. Excited to introduce to you Eliot Linton.
I don't have computer audio. All right. Ooh, this is, how do you tighten this? Like slips every.
Yeah. This part.
That stand for you? Yeah. Okay, thanks for coming. I know it's the most insane possible time for this to be, but here we go. Let's workshop some digital found poems. This is a long-term project. I basically made a kind of algorithmic and an algorithmic search for rhyme and meter that I then like throw large amounts of web text at and then try to pull like poems that fit like classical poetic forms. So it's like found poetry, but like with a little bit of an engine to make it like limericks or sonnets or whatever. So as a example, welcome to WordHack for the Cure. Here is a tweet that is aged like fine wine from 3 days ago that you can pair with the evergreen roses are red. So you can say, roses are red, violets are blue. So last year, 37,000 Americans died from the common flu. And then as it goes on, the head of our country like downplayed the severity of the outbreak on March 9th. So that's like already a meme template. That's like a popular thing to do for people to stick headlines or whatever after roses are red. So I like tried to spin a little meter into it. You know, like that's like vaguely anapestic, like da 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 da, roses are red, violets are blue. So I just tried to search New York Times headlines that like really fit it. So this is a handful. Roses are red, violets are blue. IBM bids the PC adieu. Roses are red, violets are blue. Why trying new things is so hard to do. Roses are red, violets are blue. Mustard on tap and vinegar too. Where is that? So it's easy to make little couplets, and that's kind of how I started. So this is some more trim tweets, and you can see, so these are just true tweets, but then if you kind of blur out pieces of them, you get a couplet. Iraq was not a mistake. You miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Which is grim. Being true to yourself equals being true to your brand. The Ground Zero Mosque should not go up where planned. It's important in poetry to kind of capture the essence of the speaker. And so I think by removing and simplifying, you can really get a deeper portrait than anyone really intended to reveal. Just completed call with President Moon of South Korea. I was not aware that Russia took over Crimea. Super good look. And so I also started like remixing, like combining source A with source B. So these are some Trump tweets that rhyme with drill tweets. Drill is sort of like the like sick poet laureate of online. He's a weird Twitter guy. He like plays a character that is like the worst possible forum poster in the universe. Because of fake news, my people are not getting the credit they deserve for doing a great job. I continue to insist as I slowly shrink and transform into a corn cob. Entrepreneurs, being stubborn is a big part of being a winner. I own 3 dildos on a shelf labeled breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So there's a saying about sculpture that I hope you'll find appropriate right now, that to carve an elephant out of marble, it's easy. All you have to do is chip away all the pieces of marble that don't look like an elephant. And so I like to think in my small way, that this project feels like taking just like text that people were writing for other reasons and then chipping away the pieces that like don't look like a poem until together they're a poem. And so I looked up, I was like, oh, I wonder if that's a real quote or who said it or whatever. And it turns out the earliest known on this unquote investigator, this guy, there's just this quote from the 1800s where some guy wrote into a newspaper maybe and said something that's not really that much like the elephant quote, but may have originated it. But then I'll just read it. It is a sculptor's power, so often alluded to, finding the perfect form and features of a goddess in the shapeless block of marble, and his ability to chip off all extraneous matter and let the divine excellence stand for itself. Thus, in every incident of business, in every accident of life, the poet sees something divine and carefully scales off all that encumbers that divinity and permits it to be revealed in all its transcendent loveliness. So kind of keep that in mind as I read these, because this is what I'm doing, is chipping away the scales off of people's online language to reveal the poetry underneath. And, Todd, are you getting a call? So to get into one like technical thing that I did, I wrote like a meter search. So very quickly, like 2 basic meters that basically all of this stuff falls into. Iambic is like you alternate stresses. So like twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. There's like an unstressed syllable between every stressed syllable. And then anapestic, you just put 2 in between. So like that's Dr. Seuss and some other stuff. So my tricks are not bad, said the cat in the hat. So I would input like a little query like this, where the 1s mean stresses and the 0s mean non-stresses. And then the program can like chunk through the text and be like, okay, this chunk fits, this chunk fits, this chunk fits. And then I kind of comb through it and find pieces that work together. And then this is just sometimes like you can have like pickups, or you can have like a couple syllables at the beginning that aren't, maybe don't like look like they fit the exact meter, but it's okay if they're there. So this is all to say that I like accounted for that and allowed for like variable searches for a lot of this. So, to get right into meter, Shakespeare wrote in a lot of iambic pentameter, so I tried to find some New York Times headlines that could fit with lines from Shakespeare's sonnets to make kind of beautiful prophetic couplets. Yet do thy worst, old time, despite thy wrong. Sam Smith will sing the new James Bond theme song. The latest on the Ryan Lochte case to put fair truth upon so foul a face. how running may or may not help the heart, for still temptation follows where thou art. And then, sorry, this is like drill in Shakespeare. My cries for help are muffled by my ass, and thinking on it makes me cry, alas. So just kind of two poets from throughout time connected by the wonders of technology. So this is from a cardiology textbook, just to make the point that you can kind of do this from things that are sort of boring or dry. This is just something that's free online. You get adverse effects develop due to age and sex, see figure 2. At other times, a shuffling gait is reproduced, see figure 8. And then the first thing I thought of to start this was making limericks, which are fun but kind of difficult because it's like a pretty tight restrictions. You need like 5 lines to all fit together and 3 for like the longer one to rhyme, which like I don't, if you're looking for like meaning in random text, the like shorter a line you can get is helpful. So this just like constricts it a lot. But whatever, there's still a lot of limericks coming in the pipe. So this is another limerick, or this is a limerick by Drill, kind of about self-improvement, improving yourself, looking to a new year for a new you. We'll click only 3 links today, go to a YMCA, gain muscle mass, unclog my ass, be sent to Guantanamo Bay. I already kind of got into Drill, but sometimes it helps to explain. If people haven't seen him, a lot of these don't hit that well. Whatever, we'll get right into it. The correct thing to do on this page is to cover your body in rage and debate the real shit every moment of it to make around minimum wage. I put 1,000 bees on my dick. I'm gonna upload a pic. If you follow me, it's intended to be fucking remiss to not click. We're back to Trump. The destruction of civilization was never a big motivation. Putin has shown we take care of our own at the Trump Organization. There's like a huge corpus of wine reviews that are super fun to pull stuff from because wine reviews are like abundant and like incredibly repetitive. And actually pretty constrained, like fancy words, but pretty short, simple sentences. So you can get stuff like, easily one of the best made anywhere in the Northwest. It has flavors of spice complex and precise that set it apart from the rest. Accents of incense and myrrh, an impression of orange liqueur. For $8 you get a 10% bianchetta, whiff of wet animal fur. The tannins are polished and firm, and resin aromas confirm hints of petrol and lime that may worsen with time. It's a wine for the medium term. We're back. Baby born with a foot in its brain. How do I cope with the pain? I drive off a cliff by trying to sniff fucked up drugs known as cocaine. Okay, this is now limericks made only with just like booked full book titles. I got a list of like great books from Goodreads or whatever. The Picture of Dorian Gray, No Exit and 3 Other Plays, Call of the Moon, Children of Dune, Star Trek, Log 7 and 8. The Case of the Curious Bride, The Crying of Lot 49, Rabbit at Rest, Infinite Jest, CSS, The Definitive Guide. Poetry can be anywhere, and it's within us the whole, you know, all along. I also messed around with ballad form, which is just like, it's iambic, and it goes kind of 8 syllables, 6 syllables, 8 syllables, 6 syllables. A fun fact people love to know is that, like, you can sing a lot of songs interchangeably because this was such like a popular form in English musical tradition for such a long time, like, you know, a lot of church hymns and then some other stuff. So like you can sing the Pokemon theme song to the tune of House of the Rising Sun if you want. So one thing I found out just while like trying this, I had a list of proverbs and the proverbs just seem to like snap right into this. Potentially because like a lot of like English, like common history used to be transmitted through like poems and songs, but I don't really know that. But it seems pretty believable. So do people want to pick a tune on this list to sing a few proverbs to? Pokemon. All right, we're going to start with Pokemon. Hup, are we going to do it together?
Can you
people? All right. Hats on backwards. A picture paints 1,000 words. A stitch in time saves 9. Do, 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 do. Don't put the cart before the horse. Don't throw pearls to swine. Youth is wasted on the young. Look before you leap. Be-do-do-do. A woman's work is never done. Practice what you preach. English proverbs. So I looked at emails from Beto's 2020 campaign mailing list and made a quick ballad. I'll do it to God Rest You Merry Gentlemen. Reach out to any friends of yours, help spread the word about a team to knock 10,000 doors to get our message out. 2020 means we beat in just a few short days Warren, Bernie, Sanders, Pete, and make sure Beto stays. I don't know the real tune of this one that well. Every dollar makes a difference up and down the ballot. Join us in making history against the greatest challenge. All right, thank you. So that was the ballad of Beto. Really helped. And then here's a quick rhyme reveal. I'll just read it. Asian spice and coffee cream form the bright bouquet. A touch of whole vanilla bean is never far away. The palate feel is smooth and round. The color is burnished gold. Although the cherry fruit is sweet, the sweetness is well controlled. A final minerality gives a bit of extra grip. A fleshy, fairly tannic grab invites another sip. Candied lemon, peach, and pear, a pretty shade of pink. A wine to drink with upscale fare. Noir that makes you think. Here's a quick one I also got. There was a big data set. Somebody did an article being the Gmail algorithm determines whether emails get sent to spam or get sent to notifications or your main inbox. And so we subscribe to all these political candidates to see who Google's algorithms secretly bias. And then other people were like, Google's algorithms are so tailored to who you are that if you open a new email account with nothing going on, it's not a very good sample, but whatever. We learned something maybe. But I pulled the data set for a lot of just campaign emails. So this wound up coming out kind of like a cheer. So you can imagine Amy's campaign staff kind of cheering themselves and Amy on. Last week's strong debate performance, she's been racking up endorsements. She's polling in the double digits. Let's put Amy on the ticket. Winning big is no small task. He's raising huge amounts of cash. We're counting on you, team. Click here to help us hit our end of year. Which again, this was all in there. This sort of rah-rah spirit was in there, but it takes just kind of the touch of a digital poet to make it all express so beautifully. This was a fun corpus for me. I pulled a bunch of sections of Wikipedia articles that are about animal behavior, basically by just pulling anything that seemed to be an animal that had a section with the word behavior in it. I took it, and this is Wikipedia's range of animal behaviors. It really gets it all. Life, death, birth, so you can get animal facts that are in pentameter. You can get, they take a while to chew their grass or hay. The other species needs to stay away. The great horned owl will also crush the bones found in the moist earth under buried stones. Here's a quick tale. The females give adults and chicks a place to live composed of sticks. The nest is made in winter snow. 3 eggs are laid. The nestlings grow. The couple spends its time in trees. The male pretends to walk with ease. Behind their ears, the chick is killed. The snake appears, her stomach filled. And that was all just Wikipedia writers for no pay, just filling us in on the world. I also did a bunch of these to Emily Dickinson's meter, which is similar to ballad meter, but with literally just 1 foot less at the beginning. you know, imagine that this is sort of a beautiful poetic expression about the animal world around us. Across the forest floor, on bare or grassy ground, a sambar stamps its feet and makes the most iconic sound. To hunt aquatic prey, the shoebill often stands with one or two dependent young in shallow coral sands. Alighting on the ground above the fish's eyes, they wait to ambush passing prey, relying on surprise. Okay, this is just as beautiful. This is somebody made something. Okay, so GitHub is a website where people share code with each other, like often teams of professional programmers. And anytime you like add some code and want to like push it up to the project, you need to like add a message to like just record, like, here's what I did, this is what this is about. And somebody just made a bot that like scraped any of the time that that happens publicly. If somebody swears in it, they just tweet it out. So sometimes people are like, you know, upset about the work that they're doing and kind of venting a little as they document. And so somebody recommended I, you know, scrape that and try to make stuff out of it. And so now we have kind of the beautiful frustration of programming computers. Fix shitty shader loading. I fucking hate encoding. I just switched to master. Damn, this is so much faster. The CSS is shitty. Revert to last committee. I hate this fucking job and every obj and mob. Deleting shitty code on fucking last commit. Committing right to master because I suck at Git. And here's a little bit. You can see, you know, how the sausage is made. It started out just like this, but ooh, now it's a poem. Health component makes the loop for bulk insert, so very, very fucking slow. Revert, revert, revert. This was like somebody released a data set for like measuring how people interact with airlines on Twitter. Often the red in these bars is how often it's negative versus neutral or positive. You can't really see those, but some examples of why people are mad at airlines. So we have a little bit of what comes out of that. A month ago, you lost my bags. I need to know those luggage tags. You sold my seat and called me hun. Delete this tweet. What's done is done. Thank you, American Air. I emailed your customer care. Had to give up because it most certainly was as easy as asking a bear. Here's another, you know, the magic of poetry. I need to complain to AA because of a weather delay. Hour 15 in this flying sardine. Is anyone working today? You know, Twitter is the human project of our age. And this is sort of what we're putting out into the world. And we need to keep that in mind. So this is like a very similar data set. It's just like general broad customer support. My iMessage fucked up again. What are we paying for then? Ruin my day. How much do I pay to go back to iOS 10? Hello, I'm trying to get myself money and get out of debt. I ordered on Prime this morning and I'm now sober enough to regret. This one, decide for yourself. Damn, a McGriddle would hit. I'll give it a shot in a bit. Breakfast before I get to the store, you'd make so much money from it. Does he know about McGriddles? Did he just invent McGriddles? Where are we? All right. Someone explain please to me why I've been blocked by the Sheikh of Dubai. My dick has become disrespected by scum. People used to jack off to this guy. Okay, this is a full sonnet that I made out of wine reviews. Basically, this process is like, it's super hard to get like meaning going for more than like half a sentence or more than like one little sentence. So longer forms tend to be harder. But the wine reviews are just so easy to, I don't know, they're just like, they work super well. They're very like modular and repetitive. So here is you know, winemag.com presents your wine reviewed in a sonnet. Inviting with its hearth spice, plum, and smoke, it's lively, very crisp, demanding food, complexed with sweet green herbs and smoky oak, but not the best Alenda we've reviewed. The barrel flavors tend to overpower with wayward oak that needs to settle in. A jagged mouthfeel framing sweet and sour might strike some tasters as a little thin. The wine is at or slightly past its peak, not open or inviting at this time. We'll get you through a party or midweek, okay, with applesauce and lemon lime. It's black as ink and clumsy as can be, imported by Small Vineyards, LLC. And then one quick last thing. The final application of this is sort of improving historical poetry, written by people who didn't always remember to rhyme, didn't always remember to stick really rigidly to common meter structures. So this is just like kind of a dust up, of the past so that we can all benefit, from sort of the wonders of technology. So this is us forcing Walt Whitman to rhyme. I would sing in my copious song what the singers were singing so long, a conflict with foes, the clatter of blows of the youngest men 2,000 strong. And then sort of a longer, a sunset on the Norway coast that fullest feeds and freshens most. I walk these broad, majestic days to plow the land and spring for maize. Green blades of grass and warbling birds, they answer all, but not in words. They tumble forth, they rise and form. Amid the wilds, the rocks, the storm, find what I sang erewhile so hard, yet louder, higher, stronger, bard. I chant, I see it rise, I scan. The earth is not an echo, man. A holy calm descends like dew, the world of 1492. It's obviously, it sounds better if they're a poet, because they were, like, working harder. And he, like, wrote whatever. He wrote in meter and he rhymed some, but it is sort of perverse to do this to his stuff. And that's why we must. And then this is one I like. This is sort of a different algorithm. If you guys want to check out, I have a website called puns.plus where you can search for all the puns you want. So if you're like, I want red words that sound like car words. It doesn't load and you can't do it. But you can get like, like Carmine Red Wreck, Chevron Chevy, Pink Pickup, Amber Lamborghini, Khaki Cabby. And then you can restrict it to be like, okay, I want it to like, it must like follow like vowel rhymes or whatever. So like teal wheel, green limousine, pewter scooter, tan sedan. Anyway, so using that, I just like really quickly tuned up kind of a Carlos Williams classic. So the way it went before was so much depends upon a red wheelbarrow glazed with rainwater beside the white chickens. And you can see that this time we're going to go, okay, no, not red. Okay, so much depends upon a russet bucket, spongy with sunshine beside the turquoise turkeys. And William Carlos Williams can be spinning gratefully in his grave. That's super it. If people want to test out, this is like my take home, if people want to test out puns.plus, it is super, has room for improvement, but it's fun. So that's the domain name. Remember it if you want, and talk to me about it if you play around with it. Not a moment too soon or too late.
Thanks, Eliot, and hello, logician, and hello, all of you. We're going to take a quick little 5-minute break, get set up for the next performance. You are welcome to grab a drink, hang out, chat, talk to someone. We have some flushable wet wipes around if people are feeling their hands. We'll be back with Fernando's online performance in, let's say, 5 minutes or so.
Hey. For the next one, we don't really need this, right? It can just be the
Right, we don't need the camera.
Can you hear me?
Thank you.
Alrighty, everybody. We got another performance here for you. We've got a remote performance here from Fernando Ramallo. He's a creator of games and other sorts of playful media, an artist, and a really fun member of our local community here. Excited to have him deliver a remote performance for us here. So please give it up. I think I'll be able to hear you. Give it up for Fernando.
Woo!
Yeah.
Hello, Word Hack. We are 20 seconds apart. Our communications are delayed. So your patience is up. Appreciated. Let us begin. Everyone watched. Telefi. The lead TV network in Argentina. It would play The Simpsons. So, everyone.
Te escuchará gritar Alien 3 con Sigourney Weaver. Estreno este lunes a las 10 de la noche por Telefe.
My first exposure to America. Was through the ads. Movies and shows playing here. Dubbed in Spanish. By Mexican companies. There were only two dubbing studios. And they did all the movies and shows around. Soma. Sounded like the Terminator. Because it was the same actor.
Mira, así un poquito de relax. Relax, exactamente, relax. Yo como para divertirme, ¿no? Tin, 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 chao.
America came in the form of...
Tomátelo con Gatorade.
Rant.
Para la sed Gatorade. Nada funciona mejor.
La Susana.
Este jueves una noche muy especial de Hola Susana. Con una visita
famous
espectacular. Recién llegado a la Argentina, Jean-Claude Van Damme. La superestrella del cine de acción. En su primera visita a nuestro país. En un reportaje exclusivo de Hola Susana. Jean-Claude Van Damme. En su primera aparición en la televisión argentina. Además,
todo es High Endurance. Eso significa que dura más, porque al evaporarse más lentamente, protege mejor.
Comprobado. Old Spice cambió. Por eso, yo cambié por Old Spice.
Probalo. Si no te gusta, llamás y te devuelven a
América.
En barra y en aerosol.
In the form of deodorant. And batteries.
Con hojas de palmera.
No te arriesgues. Nada supera a Energizer. Energizer. Siguen andando, y andando, y andando, y andando.
Como policía fue castigado. Ahora no se detendrá hasta descubrir la verdad. Los Quilicen. Zona de impacto.
Policía de los mejores. Sin embargo, testificó contra unos policías. Llamaba por acusado de homicidio. Recorre ahora los bajos fondos a la casa de proscritos. Es un cazador de recompensas.
American
es
word.
Un
places.
Lorenzo Lamas es renegado. Éxito en los Estados Unidos. Cada día más cerca del 13.
¿Qué tal, amigos? Quiero saludar a mi amigo Marcelo Hugo Tinelli.
American Politic.
Estamos mirando vía satélite aquí en la Casa Blanca con
Hillary.
Te pido, Tinelli, que le mandes un beso a tu esposa, Paula. ¿Cómo era su apellido? Paula Jones. No, esa era otra. La verdad, Paulo. Thank you.
Señor Jefferson, me llamo Lisa Simpson y tengo un problema.
Sé cuál es tu problema. Que el monumento a Lincoln estaba abarrotado.
Perdone, señor.
Nadie viene nunca a verme. No les culpo. Nunca hice nada importante. Solo la declaración de independencia,
American
la adquisición de Luisiana, la invención del montaplata.
Ya veo que le he cogido en mal momento, señor.
Espera,
just
no te
vayas.
Me siento aquí tan solo. ¡Montaplata! No. Me siento aquí tan
solo. Oye, oye, ¿no puedes entrar?
Oh no, is there Adam?
And so we learned about America.
Parrillada!
Se llama el pozo sin fondo de la parrillada.
Through jokes.
Y aún saboreo la salsa de los dedos. Y ahora prepárate. Es todo lo que puedas comer.
Es como, love. Como un hermoso sueño.
Sábados de superacción desde la acción. ¿No hay... de superacción desde las 2 de la tarde con TLP.
So what's America to me? Having turned into a citizen a few days ago. America still looks like Richard Gere being invited by Telef for his first performance with Susanna Gimnes.
Richard Gere, invitado especial de TNP.
Fernando, are you there?
Thanks, bye.
oh.
Yes. Hi.
Hi, Fernando.
Thanks. Literally hearing this 20 seconds later.
Your head looks great.
Anyways, love you. Bye.
Great. Bye, Fernando. Okay. Yeah. Well. Maybe we'll leave you up here for the. Nope. All right. Well. yeah. Let's give it up one more time for Fernando. Right. Cool. Well, that's our show. It's a short one for you this evening, but I want to give another hand to all our featured presenters for Eliot coming out. And, yeah. So WordHack tends to be on the third Thursday of the month. This is the part where I usually tell you about the lineup for next month's WordHack, but for maybe I don't want to get you too excited about it, because we do have some people currently lined up, but stay tuned. You know what I'm going to have you do? I'm going to have you go to our Facebook event or our With Friends event and hop on the WordHack email list. That way I can let you know what exactly is going to happen. Possible it might be an all online version of WordHack, or it could be a, I don't know, maybe we can come back here again. Who knows? Who can say at this point? But there will certainly be WordHack years down the line that I will see you all at. So I'll see you next March for sure. Cool. That's all we have. I'll catch you next time. Be safe. Be well. And see you later. And by streams, we'll try and stream some more word hacks for you real soon.
Summer goes.